I'm speechless. Right now, just a little before 3 a.m. in the morning, I woke up to an awful burning sensation. I put my hand on my left arm that is on the outside of the bed. It hurt and came away wet, like it was bleeding. I'm laying there in the dark, jolted out of a dead sleep, thinking, what the heck? So I jump up and run into the bathroom and turn on the lights. The lower part of my arm isn't bleeding, but it has a long burn on it. There is blistering now, a long red welt, and the skin is raised and hurting from it. I don't know how anything like this can happen. My boyfriend came running in the bathroom, staring at me and my arm in disbelief. He's never believed in the paranormal before, asking what's wrong. I put something for burns on it and it stopped hurting so much. He got out the camera and took a picture of it. It's began to blister now. Now he's so scared he won't go back in our bedroom. He's in the spare bedroom sleeping while I type this out. I usually don't talk much about my experiences, but now I'm being attacked. Worse than the scratches a few years before. Now something is burning me. I need some advice, but I don't know where to turn. I'm afraid to go back to bed. I guess I'll just stay on the couch and turn on the TV until I can go back to sleep. This happened to me in December of 2016. It blistered up and popped open. It was awful and painful. I have called so many paranormal phone numbers, but no one replies. There's a television show called The Dead Files, and I did reach the producer on the phone once. They couldn't come out and do an investigation because we don't own the house, but now we do. I will look for that number again since things are more active around my place again. Nothing that serious has happened to me until this past November 2019. First, I heard tiny bells ringing in my bedroom as I laid in bed to go to sleep. I have some little tiny bells on a strip of cloth laying over my mirror. It was attached to a blouse, and I cut them off to save them since the blouse didn't fit me anymore. I discovered that was the sound I heard the next morning. Then a few more nights later, as soon as my head hit the pillow for sleep, a bell started jingling right beside me. I was so scared I jumped up and turned on the light. Nothing there. Later the next day, I found a walking stick I had added a little bell to. I had forgotten all about it. It was right across from my bed. I've moved it since then because it freaked me out. Then this past November the 7th, I was laying in my recliner and not moving at all. I was watching TV when something jabbed me in the lower part of my left leg. I yelled out in pain and began rubbing it with my other leg. I didn't know what to think and just laid there in the chair. I had the leg that got stabbed hanging over the side of the chair for a while. I got up for something. When I came walking back to my chair, I saw three big drops of blood on the carpet. I began cleaning it up. I didn't know what to think as I stood up from cleaning the blood up. I had a long nightgown on and raised it to see that my leg had been bleeding and the blood was on both legs, and all over my nightgown. I'm once again speechless and don't know why these kinds of things are happening to me. I feel helpless and very alone trying to talk about it with people.